Hello everyone, I'm Mr. Revolutionary. Today I'm going to be reviewing the Phantasm series. It's a series of movies by Don Coscarelli, horror movies. Originally started in 1979, and they're still making them. There's Phantasm 5 coming out next year, so I figured, why not review all of them right now? And I haven't found a good review of Phantasm, the whole series, online anywhere. So, because the one thing about Phantasm is you can't spoil it. No spoilers. So there won't be any spoilers in this review. So anyway, let's start with Phantasm 1. Now the first Phantasm is very atmospheric. It's dark. It doesn't show you a lot. You're in this town, and you're following this guy. Sounds intriguing. You're following this guy who's his cousin, brother's former roommate, a relative of his dies, and they go to his funeral and everything. And so, and the great thing about it is you don't know the layout of the town. Like, everything is very mysterious. Like, they go places, but it's more of like they travel in the dark and then they reach their destination. So it's very psychological. You don't know where they're at, you kind of don't know what they're doing, and for this movie it works great because you can follow these characters without really knowing where they are. It makes no sense. It's very... I make it sound terrible. Now the series has a really great villain in the Tall Man. Now he's this mysterious tall funeral home owner, director, guy. Anyway, he's seemingly... Well, let's just say he's mysterious. I'm not going to spoil the movie, so it's going to be hard to talk about it without spoiling it. But anyway, point is, he's a great villain. And then I'm not going to say anything else because the movie ends. The movie goes on, it's mysterious. There's not many jump scares, really, at all, which makes it great. It's just a very atmospheric, scary feeling throughout the entire movie. And that's it. I'm not going to say anything else. My rating, 10 out of 10. It's a masterpiece. Fantastic movie. Now on to Phantasm 2. Now Phantasm 2, I didn't like it first. I didn't care for it at all. It's not as dark, it's not as mysterious, it's a lot more straightforward, more of an action movie. Plus it has a lot bigger budget. It gets a lot bigger budget, not as good a movie. It's got good things about it. It's got some good action, some cool stuff, some cool scenes in it. And it picks up immediately where Phantasm 1 ends, which is that's crazy. There's not many movies that actually do that, which you'll find in this entire series. Phantasm picks up right where the last one left off. Phantasm 3 does it, and so does Phantasm 4, which is crazy even to think about. I mean, you see these actors, you know, the movies are made over like 30 years, and you see them age, but the movies end, you know, they pick up right where they end, so it's crazy. Anyway, Phantasm 2, more of an action movie. They have a different main actor in the lead role, but he's fine. There's nothing wrong with him. It's got some psychological elements, but it's much more straightforward, much easier to follow. So anyway, it's pretty good. It's kind of just your standard fare. But anyway, 6 out of 10 would be my rating of it. It's worth watching just because it's the Phantasm series. And I'll tell you, all these movies are worth watching, but only because of the fourth one. And I'll get there. Anyway, so Phantasm 2, 6 out of 10. Now Phantasm 3 has better effects, has as good effects as Phantasm 2, which Phantasm 2 had better effects than number 1, but Phantasm 3 has good effects, not that great a movie. It has a Home Alone thing to it a little bit for part of it, which is fine. There's some parts that I like about it, and it's definitely unique. It's has more ghosts in it and things like that. It's more ghost-like. They bring back the original actor in the first from the first movie, which is cool. But I'm not going to say much about it. It's got some good effects, some good action, but it's not much of a Phantasm movie. I mean, it's not very mysterious and things. I mean, there are mysterious things to it, but it doesn't really add anything new to the series. So, 5 out of 10. It's an average movie. It's not that great for a Phantasm movie, but it's still worth watching because of number 4, Phantasm 4, Oblivion. Phantasm 3 was called Lord of the Dead. I don't think I said that. But Phantasm 4, Oblivion is awesome. It's a great movie, and it has one of the lowest budgets of the movies. I think it has the lowest budget. But it's so psychological, it's atmospheric, it's interesting. And it's much more of a mystery than 2 or 3. And so that was the camera. It ran out of juice, out of memory. I'll keep going. Phantasm 4, it has a lot of mystery to it. It's very atmospheric. But it has a lower budget, and so the effects are still well done. There's just not as many effects. And it's not as long of a movie either, which is good because it shows exactly what it needs to show. It doesn't have anything that drags on for too long, and it has some very clever scenes. There's scenes in Phantasm 4 that no other movies could really do in a series. Stuff that I've never seen done before. And stuff that really Don Coscarelli had the opportunity to do, and he did it well. He did it fantastically. So when you see Phantasm 4, it brings up so many new questions, but it answers so few. And so it really just answers your questions with another question, another mystery, which is cool because it adds layer upon layer of mystery to Phantasm, and it makes the tall man even more interesting than he was. So it's got good effects, it's pretty gory still. It's certainly not too long. It doesn't drag. It has it's some incredible, really cool scenes in it. Stuff that really makes you wonder what's real and what's not real, and also what part the main character has, what part he plays in the story. And so when Phantasm 4 ends, it feels like the perfect ending. It's weird because it's one of the most bizarre endings, and I'm not going to say anything about it, but it's one of the most bizarre endings, and yet it's just perfect for Phantasm. It's weird, and it makes you think, and then it's just, but it's so simple, and it's great. So for Phantasm 4, I'd give that one a 9 out of 10. It's not as good as the first movie, and I was debating whether I would give it an 8 or a 9 out of 10, but I think the more you think about Phantasm 4, the better it gets. So I think 9 out of 10. Very, very good movie. And as I said before, all the movies pick up right where the last one left off, so it's really cool. Anyway, Phantasm 4, great movie. Phantasm 5 is coming out in 2016, which it was supposed to come out in 2015, but I guess it got delayed. And it's not going to be really necessary, because Phantasm 4 ended good. But it could be good. That's all I'm going to say, is it could be good. I don't know what they're going to do with it, but it could be good. Anyway, guys, I'll see you later. I've been Mr. Revolutionary, giving you my thoughts and review on Phantasm series. It's a great series. Highly recommended. 2 and 3 aren't that great, but they're not bad, and they really set things up for Phantasm 4. It really sets things up for the perfect finale. So anyway, I guess I'll see you guys next time. Ta-ta, take it easy.